Welcome back to a playthrough by That One Gamer for Star Wars Shadows of the Empire on the N64. So this guy here, this droid, is named Levo. He's basically the first mate of the Outrider, kind of like how Chewbacca is for the Millennium Falcon. So he'll give you little hints and plot stuff, important plot points later throughout the level. He doesn't really do much overall, and you can't play as him. He's just a supporting character, mainly. So in this case, because of the big the shield generator being taken out, you gotta activate the emergency generators. Now this game is unique, because you just saw there, you can actually play in third person or first person. I usually prefer first person because when I play it like this mode, Dash can sometimes block my view of some enemies. So, this is what he looks like basically. He carries a blaster pistol similar to Han. And this also has a unique view called movie camera, where it kind of emulates that of a movie feel, like it'll cut to different camera angles depending on your viewpoint. But it's not very practical. You'll notice that there's no crosshairs whatsoever. So this can be a little bit of a problem on some parts, but he'll automatically aim towards the enemies, at least the non-boss enemies. As mentioned, Jedi mode is unique because, you see Millennium Falcon over there. Usually the enemies on the highest difficulty are the strongest and have the most stamina. That's not the case. Sure, they're the strongest attack, but you have strong attack too. So they can take you out in two hits, you can take them out in one or two hits. So, I'm really careful. So, Falcon there. Several enemies around here. Notice that they didn't disappear, which is unique. You might be wondering, whoa, there's a Falcon right there. Is Darth Vader around there? Unfortunately, in the game, no. It's just a little teaser there by the developers. Alright, so where's the dudes at? I know there's someone there. You might be wondering where the music came from for this one, because half the music from here, this game, is a partial version of the original's trilogy. In this case, this song here plays during the attack of the Death Star in the very first Star Wars movie, A New Hope. That was close. When the X-Wings are reporting in. All wings report in, red 10 standing by. Red 11, all that. Red 2 standing by. Red 6 standing by. All that stuff. Lock cast foils and attack positions. Oh, crap. Crap. See that? Oof. I forgot there was a guy over there. Oh, the two guys. So I knew there was a guy, but... as mentioned before, they don't disappear, and that's because there is a finite number of enemies in every single level, other than some of the vehicle levels. Actually, just one vehicle level, the very last one, now that I think about it. And, so that was a healing icon, basically, back there. See that? One shot. And you notice the ammo of this blaster is different. Mm-hmm. So instead of being like 100 ammo, it's a percentage of how strong each shot is. So the first shot does 100, second shot does about 80 something, and so on down. But other power-ups that you can get here, those do have finite ammo. And when I think about it, Jedi mode is probably the closest to actual Star Wars damage, in the sense that it only takes one shot to take out a stormtrooper or anyone for that matter, other than armored foes like maybe Darth Vader or Boba Fett. Except for a point blank range, but anyway. Here we go. Well, that was a challenge point that I picked up earlier, that spinning gray thing. So that's what they actually look like in the game. And you'll notice it's the insignia of the Rebels. I'm gonna do back here. Where is it? And let's go on the other side. Here we go. Ah, damn it. Now look at that, we got some wampas in here. You don't usually see that. So, on medium and hard mode, I think that's usually a seeker missile. So, just unlock here. Got it right here. And they see that? The wampas are actually fighting each other. So as long as you don't fire at them while they're caged, they'll end up still fighting against each other. So you let them take each other out, take out the last one, and then pick up the item in question. Kind of reminds me of Spectre. Three fighting fish, one stays behind, only lets the other two fight it out. And then once they warn each other out, strikes, just like Spectre. I love that one. Yeah. Damn it! I knew it was there, but... he was ready as well. Oof, fine. So I'm gonna show you as many items and all that stuff. I'm gonna get every single challenge point in the game. Crap. Oh, what? Yeah. Well, I bet they're all gonna go after me now. Watch this. Well, he's coming back. He can actually open doors too. Wampa can take you out in one swing, that I know, so. Well, obviously, watch out. If ever you're close to these things. Alright. You might be wondering, where do those boxes come from in the movie? I don't remember seeing those anywhere. Well, there's only one instance that I can think of where I see these types of boxes, and that's in A New Hope, after the Death Star, the tractor beam from the Millennium Falcon. At some point, the scanning crew comes aboard, and it holds a red rectangular device that has the squared sides, and they use that to help scan the ship. But obviously they didn't bring him to do that because, well, watch the movie, you know. Alright, let's see. Okay, there's a gun turret behind me. Enemies at the back edge of the other side of the field. Got you. Your blasters have a very good hit rate. So it's... despite having no, crosshairs or anything like that, it's still considerably easy to hit most of the enemies. I'm gonna take out these guys here. Oof. Before I go back. back now. They don't really follow you in a general sense. Alright, so there's a challenge point right over here. Oh, there we go. Seeker missiles! Any health back here that I missed? There we go. Obviously, need to get keep your health as high as possible on Jedi mode. There we go. That's good. But notice that the probe droid did considerably less damage than the enemies, and I think that was a glitch or a programming error on the developer side, because those droids like humans, do a lot of damage, but gun turrets and probe droids, nope. You can just walk across here to get the challenge point, but then you need to carefully jump. Get back out. Let's see, anything over here? Alright, now I know there's droids and some enemies. Hear the droid. Got another one. Sometimes, if you hit them and then they fall down a cliff of some kind, they'll make the Wilhelm, the famous Wilhelm scream. I see a turret over here. I don't know if I can see it. Oh, now I got it now. End of the first stage. There we go. Alright, now for the second half. Lando once described him as being like able to shoot a small object off the table, like a coin or whatever, and not even ruin the shine. So, he's very loyal as long as the money runs, he says, or something like that. Must be the other side. This is one of the generators we were talking about to operate, to turn on. So the challenge point must be on this one. I knew there was one somewhere. Let's see, on the corner. 10 overall on this particular level. Okay. There, got him. There's a probe droid flying out there. Alright. There are two enemies over here, one on the right, one on the left. So I go to the one on the right first because he's closer. And, damn! I'll have to backtrack for some help, possibly. Another one is. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna backtrack and get some health. Make sure. There we go. At that fork in the road, you can either go left or right, but I prefer to go right. I think it's easier that way. There's nothing special on the left at all, just a snowtrooper and an and/or a probe droid. I can't remember. I also remember reading about Shadows of the Empire, where it takes place, or when, where, what Dash does. He is actually on Tatooine during A New Hope. In fact, during the special edition, 1997 version of Star Wars, you can actually see the Outrider leave Mos Eisley. I believe that's as Luke and the droids, Luke, Obi-Wan and the droids are approaching Mos Eisley. Okay, probe droid there, and there's an enemy over here. So that's how influential Shadows of the Empire was. It was enough to actually get a cameo of the Outrider in A New Hope. One more snow tree. There we go. Okay, so up here is where the switch is to get the generators going, but there's some snow troopers. So be careful and quick, and hopefully you're in position. Afraid to jump and lose a little health. You can actually take damage by falling down from too high of a height. And even too high of a height, more than that, you can actually die. Red one there, extra light. Yay! Okay, get back on the other side here. Tend to like not use my weapons with limited ammo until the very last part of the game, because as I can tell you, the very last boss in the game is hard, so I can save most of my ammunition for him, but there are times where it's very practical to use the secret missiles. Especially when I think about it, I probably will use one or two when I get to the ship. Just to be on the safe side, I'm going to die earlier. Ooh, this part. Okay, so. It's first be on the left side, because eventually a challenge point will appear. And there are some enemies back there, so keep shooting back there to make sure you get them. But then you see the little narrow edge right here? If you wait even longer, extra life will appear. Can I get there in time? Got it! Yeah! Yes! I'm on point. There's one more challenge point up ahead, and I know exactly where it is. Okay. Up ahead, here we go. Up. On the edge here. Turn the corner, and holy shit, it's an AT-ST. How the hell? And your second thought is, how the hell did that get in there? So, you gotta fight the AT-ST, but he's incredibly easy because the AI is super poor. He just travels in a figure eight, and you're right here. So, other strategies recommend not staying here, but because it's just so poor AI, it's... Again, try to shoot the little square that connects the head and the legs. In the actual extended universe canon of the game, of the story, Dash does indeed go up against an AT-ST, and he ends up destroying it with a rocket launcher. I guess that's more or less what the sequences are. As you might have noticed, I have to angle myself to shoot it because, as I mentioned, boss characters, Dash will not automatically aim for them, except for one in the second to last level in the game. And even then, it's kind of hard to have him shoot at the right if you want to shoot at. So, a very simple boss here. Look at all those crates in here. What kind of goodies we got? If we were playing on easy mode in this, if the boss would have been an invincibility item at the top of one of these catwalks. I want to say the one over on the right here. And if you're wondering where the music in this came from, this actually comes from the Battle of Hoth, when the rebels are starting to lose ground. Imperial forces are closing in on the shield better. Look at that, seeker missiles. No. What about the hell back here? Let's jump up here. Whee! When you're in first person, you gotta have to time your jump a little carefully. You actually have to physically see the platform disappear from your viewpoint in order to get the farthest jump you can. So that way you don't jump too early. That's something that, especially when you get kind of sort of challenge points. Alright, so that's all that there. It'd be cool if you could drive one of these things. I'm guessing he got through from the door right there. What he was doing there, no clue. Alright, so last challenge point is back here. See that? Hear that? A couple wampas back there, they're fighting each other. Apparently they're not allies to each other unless you shoot at them first and then they decide to join forces and gang up on you. Oh, one of them won. And only two. So there's the last one. But you gotta be careful. You'll notice the elevation is different here. So wait till Dash. And then jump! Carefully angle yourself so you don't hit that wall on the left. And then voila. Okay, now. Really? Alright, those four stormtroopers back here on hard and Jedi mode. Two of them are immediately outside. There we go. There's at least two, but sometimes one of them comes down the ramp. Alright, so I didn't have to use a seeker after all. Okay, and there's one more down in the cockpit area. Oh, crap! How the hell did that happen? Son of a bitch! He literally snuck up on me. Where the hell? Oh, man. Figures. The one I shot must have been from the cockpit. How the hell does that happen? So, the actual cockpit's right there, but you can open any door and you'll get the same cutscene. Ay, ay, ay. Son of a bitch. So. Alrighty. So that's that level, so I'm going to stop the video here. We'll go to the next one, which is another vehicle level. This time it's in the Outrider itself, and show how that one works, and we'll see you all next time.